Bajaj Finance slipped marginally in trade. Maybe the numbers slightly below the Bloomberg estimates, at least led by higher operating expenses, if I'm not wrong, which is that the net profit didn't do as well as the NII. But these could be small blips in an otherwise very, very interesting story. Let's speak with Rajeev Jain, Managing Director at Bajaj Finance, about the numbers and the outlook ahead. Rajeev, great of you to join us. Thanks for taking the time out and speaking to us on Bloomberg Quint.
Thank you.
Small aberrations. I know it's difficult to pinpoint every quarter and try and be in the same vein as the previous few quarters, but the story for FY18 remains intact. These OPEX increase more a one-quarter phenomenon?
So OPEX increase is largely coming in as part of the design. We are accelerating our investments in geographic expansion, in investing in capabilities which help us manage our balance sheet growth. It's coming in on the back of an advertising campaign that the company is running at this point of time. It's all going into growth and capability. So it's part of the plan and will remain so for the next 2-3 quarters. And from there on, you should start to see come in line. So your observation is correct that OPEX to NIM has been higher than it has been in the last fiscal, but it's part of our plan to be ready for a much larger and a more profitable business in years to come.
So for 2-3 quarters, you said your focus will remain on expansion. So what happens to, say, for example, cost to income ratio that was 41, I guess, last year, same quarter is now 44.7. Will it move up further?
No, it's not likely to go up further from here. I mean, even sequentially it has moved. But sequentially, so apple for apple, second quarter to second quarter also, it's up. It's likely to remain here. If the overall consumer demand is stronger, you're likely to see operating leverage play out. We did have a cautious stance on the SME lending business in the last two quarters. It'll remain so for the next two quarters. So all those also have a role to play in the way we deliver our OPEX to NIM. Because we are well positioned for a stronger growth, but not at the cost of credit. So if the choice is between growth and credit, we're going to obviously choose credit. And given post-demonetization, post-GST, we continue to have a cautious stance on SME, which is 35-37% of the balance sheet.
But what kind of capex have you planned or the expansion plans for next 2-3 quarters, like you mentioned?
Fundamentally look at it another way that this OPEX to NIM is a function of loss of opportunity rather than it's dilution in earnings or dilution in opportunity rather than dilution in profitability. That's really how you have to look at it. And at 37%, 38%, profit growth or the first half of the year, profit growth of 40% is a very strong momentum for a company at a point in time when the overall bank rate growth is at 5-6%. Mm-hmm. So we are reinvesting for future by a small margin is all we are doing.
Rajeev, are you being a bit conservative when you're talking about your annual growth rate numbers? I across reports when I read and people who interacted with you mention about a 20-25% growth, 20% ROEs. If I look at what you've done in quarter one and quarter two, the numbers have been much ahead of that. Are you being conservative right now when you're talking about the year, or you are under-promising and wanting to over-deliver?
So in our business, it's best to be conservative. So that's the first step, and we intend to continue to being conservative. So that's first point. Two, I think I can reasonably say that first quarter is a difficult one to provide a very clear guidance on, given the three quarters are left. I think at this point in time, we are comfortable that we will be able to deliver a 30% plus PAT growth. So that would be an upward revision from Q1 of 25% to a 30%. And if Q3 consumer demand is good and the degree of disruption as a result of GST is low, then we could further increased guidance in by end of third quarter.
Yeah, you know, I'm not even getting into asset quality, Rajeev. I know how finicky you guys are about asset quality, so I'm comfortably assuming that that will remain steady. My question is more on consumer demand. I'm just taking a bit of a deviation of Bajaj Finance business, but you would have a pulse on what's really happening, because across the industry, when we speak to normal retailers in the city of Mumbai, they're talking about demand not having come back in a hurry at the mom and pop stores. The experience of some of the larger businesses, organized businesses, seems to be a bit different. You have a pulse across this board. What is your sense of how it has shaped up in the last 2 or 3 months?
So fundamentally, look, July until 25th, there was destocking and stocking. So the first 25 days were in general lost in the organized trade. We operate in 1,050 odd cities in India, so it took time for supplies to reach the length and breadth of the country. But since then, it's been business as usual, at least from a supply side standpoint. From a consumer demand standpoint, look, festival season for consumer discretionary, these from Navratra to till 22nd of October is the most critical time. 30-35% of the sale happens of, especially of the discretionary products that we sell. What has been happening over the last few years is urban India, which is top 35-40 cities in India or up to 50 cities in India, shop only in the last 7 days. So that I would not be able to predict for you as to how the momentum of demand is. But the semi-urban and rural demand from since Navratra has been so far, I would say, reasonably good.
So, well, Rajeev, clearly from consumer's point of view, it looks like that it is not business as usual for this Diwali. But just a quick question from my side. You recently raised 4,500 crore via QIP route. Just want to check, have you deployed that money or would you be deploying it in the second half of the year?
Yeah, so that capital being raised now for the next 3 years for us as a company. So, you know, it gets deployed as... the balance sheet growth itself in the second quarter was 3,000 crores. So it's capital being raised. We are now well covered to grow our balance sheet from current levels of 72,000 crores to probably 170,000 to 180,000 crores. So we are well covered for the next 3 years from a tier one capital standpoint.
Okay, Rajeev, possibly one last question. Your provisioning coverage ratio, if you look at it, last year, same quarter, it was much higher, above 70%. This time it is below 70%. Though QOQ, it's better. Is it a conscious decision not to provide aggressively? Do you see some recovery imminent in next quarter or so?
Last year, we were the provisioning coverage and gross NPA and net NPA were reported as required by RBI on 120 days. So, in fact, provisioning coverage on has actually improved on a year-on-year basis. Because what we are now reporting, provisioning coverage and gross NPA, net NPA is 90-day basis. So it's a significant improvement on a year-on-year basis in terms of our coverage.
Okay. And keep in mind, Bajaj Finance lowered disbursements and business loans in Tamil Nadu, and yet the growth has been so stellar this quarter. Rajeev, keep up the good work. All the best for the quarters ahead. Thanks much for speaking to us at BloombergQuint.